well. It seems like a long time since I've just sat down and did like a chatty video with you. I hope you're doing okay and you've liked my content for the last couple of weeks. It's been very Halloween orientated. It is a very hectic week for me at the moment, hence why I didn't upload a video. I think it was not last week, the week before. Me and Rich are moving into our first ever flat together and it's a bit of a hectic time, and I will be sure to give you a flat tour and let you know all the bits and pieces we have got, because we've done everything on a budget. I will be doing that maybe in the next couple of weeks. This video is all about coats. We're coming into autumn and winter now. Obviously we don't need to invest in a coat, but it would be nice to invest in a nice winter autumn coat. I have got a lot of coats, bags full of, like, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, how many coats? I think I have about 8 coats to show you from Topshop. Just a little disclaimer, I am not keeping these coats. Topshop just want me to show you what they've got in store. I'm just the messenger. I just want to show you how I would style them, how I would wear them, what I think about the colours, the textures, the type of coat, just so it gives you an all-rounded idea of what kind of coats you're going to spend your pennies on this year. I know what I'm like, I usually get a new coat every year. I try and collect a good range of colours of coats that I can actually use every year. I think I'm tempted to get one of these coats, I just don't know which one I want to get. So you're basically helping me pick which coat I want to get, really. Of course they will all be linked in the description box down below, so make sure you take a look at that if you'd like to get your hands on any of these pieces. Yeah, I really hope you enjoy this video. I'm just gonna go straight into it now. So I'm gonna show you in this way because it's gonna be a lot easier for both of us. I'm gonna show you one by one. So the first coat that I picked up, it is a simple black, sort of like maxi style. It's like a satin lapel detail. I got this in a size 6 and this was more of the premium side of things. This was £89, which is a little bit more expensive than I would buy for a coat, but the quality of this coat, like the weight of it, is just so beautiful. The satin lapels are just absolutely beautiful, and then you've also got like a nice satin inside as well. Very like London, very chic. What makes this so amazing is the fact that you could wear this in the nighttime or the daytime with a pair of chunky white trainers in the daytime and some jeans, and then in the nighttime over a really nice sleek bodycon dress. 57% polyester, 35% wool and 3% acrylic, 3% viscose, 2% nylon and 6% elastane. Got quite a lot of materials in there and a high content of wool. A lot of fluff gets stuck to it very easily, so please, if you have pets, don't go for this. Because it's that black shade, it can work with so many different things. It's so versatile. I'm just in love. The next coat that I have is super Christmassy. There is a lipstick that I have that is literally the same colour. It's MAC Cosmetics Lady Danger and it is literally exactly the same as this shade. Bright orange. It's a very fiery orange red, which I really like. It's not like a deep red. It's got an asymmetric off-center opening fasten here. You have this small button here to fasten if you want it closed up. I got this in a size small. With this coat, they only did small, medium and large, probably around an 8 to 10. I love the texture of the material. It's not an itchy material, but it is slightly brushed. It's 56 polyester, 44% wool. There is quite a high wool content in there. This is probably heading towards Christmas time to me, but I feel like you can wear this in the autumn. I really like the fact that the pockets are one of those where you go straight in, they go from upwards. When I put stuff in there, I know that it's not gonna fall out. Price wise, this is £85. I would wear this coat more as a smarter coat. Because it's a red color, it actually goes really nicely with black, any like tartan scarves, any checked print scarves, some really thick tights, some over the knee boots, black turtleneck or black plain top over the top. I am obsessed and I think it's such a beautiful coat. The next coat that I have is more of a print and I absolutely love this. I think it's so beautiful. The fabric is just so soft. Probably one of my favorites. This print was very in last year and it has come back with a full-on bang this year. The Prince of Wales check mixed with this dogtooth sort of check. I really like the big collar lapels on there. It has a lot more buttons, 1, 2, 3 here, 2 here, and then another one there. Those two are like fake, you're not gonna use them. They are there just for detail. On the inside, it is more of a navy lining. Got this in a UK 4 and it is fits very oversized, so I would size down with this one. It is £79. It is in a maxi style, so it actually comes down to maybe my ankles, you know, or mid-calf, I'd say. Thick and really nice and heavy, which is what I love in a coat. I think they fall and move a lot better. 52% polyester. We've got 17% acrylic, 15% viscose, and 11% nylon, 3% cotton, and 2% lain. Yeah, the cotton aspect of that is probably making it really soft, actually. Everyone gets really nervous about buying patterned coats, right? You think it's gonna go out of fashion. They always come back in fashion. So this could be something if you were gonna invest in and probably put into a capsule wardrobe where you put it into storage and then 2 years later, grab it back out. You can wear a lot of browns. It's got mustard running through it in the lining. That gives you a telltale sign that you can definitely wear mustard with it. I would wear this as a smarter coat with heels or stiletto heels at nighttime. But yeah, I absolutely love this. I think this is probably one of my faves. So the next coat that I wanna show you is something I've had my eye on for so long now. I've seen so many high street brands and designer brands do exactly the same sort of style, the same sort of colour. We probably all recognise this style and colour. This is the Borge coat and this is £79, which is the same price as this patterned one here. Love the colour. I got this in a size 6. It's slightly oversized. You can put loads of jumpers underneath, fine knits on top of fine knits, or like a big thick jumper. This is like really autumnal, but also can push into your winter coat as well. I love the dark button detail on there. It's £79, pretty reasonable. I've seen like £100 coats like this. I know Mango do one for I think it's £99 or something. This is a maxi style, which is my favorite style, as you could probably tell. You could wear this in the day or the night time, I think. Definitely wear it with black, which I absolutely love. I love black and brown. I think it's a very good combo. Got these really nice white chunky trainers from Topshop and I just have the image of wearing those white chunky trainers, these black jeans, maybe an all black outfit like this, my leopard print shopper bag. Also wear it with those neutral colours, any sort of brown. Pockets are slightly higher up, kind of like where your waist sits. We have, yeah, it's 100% polyester. So there's actually no wool content in this at all. You want more of a lightweight coat than polyester is gonna be like your best friend. This trend is such a big trend. I don't actually need to say a lot about it. The next coat is this electric blue. Oh, this is actually more of like a pastel blue, I'd say. It is a faux fur teddy coat situation, and obviously teddy coats are a must in the winter time. I bought a coral pastel color one of these last year and I just got so much wear out of it. I do this in a pink as well, but the blue just like stood out to me. I just had to get the blue. It feels very cozy, very thick, very wintry. It's gonna keep you warm and I just, yeah, I think it's absolutely beautiful. I actually have bonfire night this weekend and I'm so excited to get cozy. I've got some mittens and yeah, I just cannot wait for winter now. I'm just fed up of autumn. I got this in a size up because I wanted it to be a lot more oversized. Because it's a shorter length, you can definitely get away with having it a bit more oversized. Don't be scared to get a block color. of a coat, because I think that you can style it in so many different ways. My black attire that I have on, it would work fine with that. It also would work really nicely with some colour clashing. Things are in at the moment that you wouldn't expect to be in, like primary colours that are opposite of the wheel to each other is just one of the biggest trends at the moment. This, maybe blue and red, would work really nice. Like, I've got red lipstick on now. A sort of like a dungarees would look really cool with this. I don't know why, it gives me sort of vintage feels. Any sort of high-waisted jeans, it's not a button situation, it's a hook and eye situation. You can't actually see it where it's fastened. It's 100% polyester. It definitely feels like 100% polyester. Price wise was £69, which is a very reasonable price for a coat. Topshop are really good for getting high-end styles with high street prices. So now we're gonna move on to more of the jacket side of things. It is a really thick faux fur, grey slash silver. It looks a little bit lilac in this light. Very fluffy, it feels so beautiful. It's faux fur, which is a must. I was really happy to see that the catwalk this year was the first time the catwalk has been completely faux fur, which is, that's amazing. I absolutely love this. I think there's some sassiness to it. If you are quite a sassy person like me, you could probably wear it in the day as well. If you're going out on the town, if you're going for cocktails, if I wear a sort of midi dress or a maxi dress on a night out, which I sometimes do and will be doing a lot of the time in the winter time, then this is perfect because it's a short crop jacket. It's gonna flatter you in the best places. It isn't shredding as much as I thought it was. I literally just hugged it, and I don't actually have a lot of hair on me. I have mostly my own hair on me. 54% acrylic, 46% mode acrylic. So basically just a mix of acrylic. It doesn't feel heavy, it feels very lightweight. I got this in a size 8 and it was £79. So this is the same price as those two long maxi coats here. Obviously Topshop do student discounts, so if you're a student, get on that. What's really nice is the fastening detail is hidden. There is no big buttons on there. It's just a small fastening in the fur, which can kind of be hard to get into, if you know what I mean. Like, I keep getting lost in there somewhere because it's so fluffy. This is going to be really nice with some dark colours, navy colours. This would go really nice with some real skinny jeans and knee-high boots, I think. I have nothing else to say other than it's absolutely beautiful. This style is definitely not me, and I picked it up and I was like, I really want to give this a go, you know, because I really like the corduroy detail of this. This is like a peach coral colour, sugary pink puffer jacket, and I am not a puffer jacket girl. I think loads of people can get away with it, but I just put them on and I look frumpy. I didn't think that I was gonna like this, and then I tried it on and I was like absolutely completely blown away. What I was drawn to is the colour. It's gonna go with all your neutral colours in your wardrobe. It's gonna go with your browns, it's gonna go with your blacks. Gonna go with a lot of colours, especially around this autumn time. The sun's out but it's just cold, this is something to go for. Any shade of jean is really nice with this, which is kind of a rarity with a coat. This is a very much a day piece for me. I think that I wouldn't necessarily wear this on a night out. You've got the cropped jacket situation, which is gonna complement anything that you have on the bottom half, especially if you've got like a Chelsea boot on. It's gonna really elongate your legs. I really love the detail of the corduroy. It's also got like a lining, and attached to the lining is a cuff so that it keeps your wrist warm. This whole buckle ring accessory is on a lot of things at the moment. Coats, jackets, it's also on earrings, it's also on shoes at the moment. It comes all the way up as well, and it's big and chunky and visible. They've made it a statement thing. This is in the petite department. I'm pretty sure they have it in a regular as well, and the only size they had left was a 10. I definitely could have done with a size 6 or 8, because it's a puffer jacket, you shouldn't really go oversized. You should go your own size with it. It's £59, which is a very reasonably priced jacket. It gives this whole chavvy feel, but I really like it. I would actually wear it super chavvy with like big chunky earrings. I would wear it with big chunky trainers, as I keep talking about. It's made up of 100% cotton and 100% polyester. But yeah, I really like this, and I think that this is gonna work really nicely with this outfit, I think. So the next and final jacket is something that comes up every year, the aviator leather jacket situation. The best ones, I think, are the black ones, just because they are sleek, they go with everything. Faux fur situation on the sleeves, the faux fur collar, the silver zip detail and buckle detail at the bottom. It's one of those jackets which you can wear day and night, and it's also really reasonably priced, £65 for something like this that is going to last you such a long time. Faux leather material, the faux fur is very much like a sort of like a teddy material. It's really soft and it is lined all the way in the inside, which is amazing. I got this in a size 8, which fits me really, really well. I think a size 6 would have been too tight, a size 10 would have been too much. It is a really nice jacket to layer with like turtlenecks underneath like this. You can also wear it with jeans, you can wear it with like a more smarter occasion, like some a leather skirt would look really sleek with this. I think this would go absolutely beautifully with my Doc Martin, my Jaden Doc Martin. Do you know what I really like about this is the length. It comes at a really nice length on me. It's just over my bum, but not too much over my bum. It's like my mid bum. 100% polyester. That's definitely because of the faux leather situation here. Perfect for autumn into winter. It's just a really nice piece, I think. And you can definitely dress it up and dress it down. So that is it, guys. All the links will be down below if you need that. If you'd like more videos like this, please let me know. I will be coming back with some more videos after the flat has been done. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, because I'd much appreciate that. I love how my channel's growing and you guys are helping me. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in my next video.